Welcome back to the third class of Mahindra Chawla School of Interior Design Technology, MCSIDT. In this third class, we will be discussing the topic of measuring a room. So you have to start with making a sketch of a room. Assume your room is a rectangle. So sketch a rectangle, put in the positions of the door, the windows, wherever they are, and if there is any corner column projections, so please mark those. Once the sketch is ready of the plan, then you start from the main door. You measure the width of the door, including the frames out to out, write it on the sketch, and then from there onwards you go clockwise around the room and go on writing the measurements of each of the lengths. So after the door, suppose from the end of the door you take it to the starting of the column, then the length and breadth of the column, then after that you measure the length of the wall. If assuming there is no window on this wall, you measure the length of the wall from the end of the column to the beginning of this column and write it on the plan. Next, of course, same thing, the length and the breadth of the column at the corner. Assuming after this you have a wall up to the window, starting of the window, you measure this length, write it on the plan. Then comes the window, measure the width of the window including the frame, write it on the plan, and you continue all the way around back to the door. So you will be ready with the plan of the room with the measurements all over. That was in the plan. Now you make a sketch of each of the four walls. Again, make a rectangle. If there is a window on this wall, sketch a window. Measure the height of the window sill from the floor finish. Measure the height of the window from bottom to top. Measure the height from the top of the window to the bottom of the beam, if there is a beam projection, and then the depth of the beam, projection of the beam, and the height of the beam till the ceiling. In case there is no projected beam, you should measure the height from the top of the window to the ceiling and you write it down. Similarly, do this for all the four walls. I hope you have understood the method of measuring a room and making a sketch and writing down the measurements. Now, what if you need to measure more than one room? Suppose you need to measure an entire apartment. So once you have measured this particular room, from the door you measure the thickness of the wall and then continue outside the back of the wall into whichever room it is, and go on continuing into different rooms till you come back to the same wall door. So first you have to make a sketch. You have to try to fit the whole plan in one paper. If not, you can continue parts in other pages, but you have to remember the connection. So you have to write point A where you left on this page, and point A you write on the other page, point A, so you know that this is the same point which you have to continue while drafting on your computer or your drafting table. So this way you'll be able to make the plan of the entire apartment. So if you have any questions, please do not hesitate to ask me. I'll try to answer as many as possible and as soon as possible.